Let me show you how to view and create a dashboard. Now, after you select the dashboards tile from the home page, you're going to be greeted with all of these dashboards. Now, a dashboard, of course, contains data visualizations, and some of the dashboards you're going to see here are out of the box from Exabeam. Some of them you might have been created by your colleagues, and in a minute, I'm going to show you how to create your own. Now, before we do that, let me talk a little bit about how to view dashboards from this page. Notice that dashboards can be tagged. This is going to allow you to filter for dashboards that have something in common and share the same tag. You can also mark a dashboard as a favorite with this star button, so you'll view those on the Favorites tab. And you can also change the overall view. So you got a lot of dashboards, you can choose List View. This way you can see more on your screen and scan the list with ease. Dashboards you create, well, those are going to appear on the My Dashboards tab, no surprises there. And that leads us to talking about creating a new dashboard. To get started, select the New Dashboard button. This will allow you to give it a name, a description, always a good idea to have a naming convention here. And then you can add relevant tags, and once you're done, click Create Dashboard. Now, a brand new dashboard doesn't really have anything in it, of course. And we're going to begin with a text tile. So I'm going to choose Add Text. Now, this is a useful way to describe the purpose and function of your dashboard, and that's to store it in like a text tile. So you can put things in here like lists, links, important information. You can even put, resources. I'm going to put a picture in here too. Let me show you how to do that. I'm going to pull that in from our website. And I've got that staged here in Notepad, so I'm just going to copy and paste that here. And we're done. Now, it doesn't look like much yet, but we're going to adjust the size with the bottom right-hand corner. So you can do this with any of your tiles so that they fit the way you like them. And there we go. We got our text tile. We can shuffle it around here from side to side. Now we're going to hit Save. And then the last thing I could do here is publish this and share it, but I'm not quite ready for that because I want to add more to this. I want to add some actual visualizations. So I'm going to click Edit, and then choose the Add Tile button and Add Visualization. From here, I need to select where I want to get my data. So this is the Event Store. This is where kind of the bucket of data, where the data is stored in the cloud. So I'm going to select that. And now I've got a list of my fields here. Now, important thing, I'm going to choose Event here, and notice two important things, dimensions and measures. It's important to understand these. Dimensions are where you're going to find your fields and values. Measures, on the other hand, this is where you can add, group, or count, and otherwise aggregate your data. So let's do an example. Let's say I want to see the number of products per vendor in my data. So I'm going to select the vendor dimension, and I could scroll through dimensions here if I want to, but I'm going to find it easier if I just type in vendor in the filter box. There it is. I just click to add it. And when you do, take note that the In Use tab actually gets incremented by one. Watch again. I'm going to type product here and add this. Notice when I do that, the in-use tab also gets incremented. And so then when I click on the in-use tab, I see three items. I see my two dimensions, product and vendor. I also see the default filter. Now, I'm going to talk a little bit more about the filter feature towards the end, but this is my two dimensions. And if I hit run, I can preview my data. Great. Now, if I select chart, though, I get an error. It tells me I'm missing something. It says I don't have enough fields, and I'm specifically missing a measure. So if you scroll down at the bottom of the chart tab, when you're building a visualization, you'll see all the different charts that are available, and they have different requirements. Now, not all of these need a measure. If you click on table, for instance, notice that works just fine. But choosing some of these other chart types, well, it actually tells you what you're missing right here. Now, for this example, let's do a word cloud for fun. When I do, I get my error. That's helpful, of course, because it tells me that I need to add a measure. So let's go back to fields and add a measure. I'm going to want to grab count. Now, my word cloud, after I hit run here, it's going to show me the number of times these vendors appear in my logs over the past couple of days. Okay, good. Now let me show you a trick though. Let me show you something different. I'm going to show you something different when it comes to measures. I'm going to delete count here with a quick click, And then I'm going to go back to fields. I'm going to type product. Now, wait, isn't product a dimension? Well, watch this. If I select this menu button right next to the product dimension, I can actually add a field-specific measure. So I'm going to select count distinct here. I've got a couple of options here, but the one that I want is count distinct. And so that will add that as a measure, as you can see here. And then, you know, I'm going to run it again and refresh it. And now my word cloud gets updated. There we go. I now have basically a word cloud that shows the number of products per vendor. And one of the things you can do is you can kind of hover over each one of the words here. I hope that was helpful. But I want to do one more example before I let you go. I'm going to delete some of these dimensions and measures. And I want to do, I'm going to look at source IP and destination IP. So let's go back and add source IP and destination IP. And when we run, click run here to refresh it. Okay, so we got a table here of source IP, destination IP. But what I want to see is how often, you know, a pair of IP addresses are talking to each other. So let's go and add the count measure. So let me do that. All right, great. Now, when I scan through my results, I notice that some of the fields don't have data in them. And I want to focus my chart a little bit better. And there's nothing better when it comes to focusing your chart than using filters. In my case, I want to remove the NA or null fields. So I'm going to go in, I'm going to add a couple of filters here that says, show me fields, only show me fields, I should say, where data is present or is not null. So let's do source IP. I'm going to do it again with destination IP. And notice you've got a lot of operators you can choose from. And when I select run, it removes those NA fields and just shows me the pairs of IP addresses. And there we go. So we've got our dimensions, our measure, and our filters. Now we can actually do a little bit more here with our filters. We can say, let's say for instance, I want to eliminate this IP address from my visualization. So I'm going to copy this address and I'm going to expand my filter statement with a subgroup. And so you can do this with and or, and I'm going to choose or. And let's say I want to do destination IP, because that's the column I pulled the IP address from. And I want to say is not, and I'm going to paste that IP address here. Now I've just eliminated that address from that destination IP column. So you can see here how powerful filters can be for you. Almost done here. Let me show you one more filter type. We also have what are called context filters. Now, these are really useful if you want to compare your results against a context table. You could say, is it in the list? Is it not in the list? So let's do an example here. Let's say we want to look at one of these IPs like source IP, and we'll choose is in the list. So is the source IP in the list? And then we can choose which context table. We're going to choose Exabeam Threat Intelligence IPs. Let me actually change this to destination IP. That makes a little bit more sense. So destination IP, is it in the list on my threat intelligence IPs? So I'm going to choose run, and that's going to update it. So my filter's in place, my dimensions, my count's in place, and I've narrowed the results quite a bit with my filters. Now, when I scroll down, I can preview those results. When I hit chart, again, I get this error message, but that's because I have the wrong chart type. So I'm going to choose bar chart and see what that looks like. There we go. I could choose column chart instead, choose different, you know, types of charts. If I'm happy with this, let me scroll up. Let's click add. I like this. There we go. I hope this was helpful. I hope you have fun creating dashboards. To learn more, check out our many other videos and e-learning. You can find a lot of links to those resources in community. Thanks for watching.